Hello, I am Louis. Today, we will learn about adaptations in animals. So, let's move on. What do you see in this picture? Oh no, you are wrong. Yes, you are right. Can you spot an owl in the picture? Oh no, you are wrong. Yes, you are right. Is this a grass twig? Is this a grass twig? Oh no, you are wrong. Yes, you are right. Have you ever wondered how animals are able to survive in the wild? Animals have certain adaptations that help them survive. Think about the way you dress in winter. Would you wear shorts and bathing suit in a blizzard? You wear warm layers of clothes and maybe even a hat and mittens to protect yourself from the weather. And what if you are having a snowball fight? You probably run away from the person throwing snowballs at you and maybe try to sneak up on that person and throw some snowballs back. The way you dress in winter, as well as the way you run and hide from someone throwing snowballs at you, are kinds of adaptations. Animals need to adapt to three things. They are habitat, food, and survival. Based on where animals live, they are grouped. Terrestrial animals live on land, aquatic animals live in water, amphibians live on both land and in water, arboreal animals mostly on trees, aerial animals fly and spend a lot of time in the air. Terrestrial animals, they adapt to live on land. They have limbs to walk, lungs to breathe, and well-developed sense organs, which keep them aware of the food and dangers around them. Example, tiger, lion, cats, dogs, and horse. Animals in plains. Animals which live in hardland surface like grasslands and forests have strong legs to run fast, to attack as well as defend. Example, lions. Grass-eating animals have toes in the form of hoofs, which helps them move on soft land. Example, deer. Burrowing animals have sharp claws or tough scales to dig the ground. Example, snake. Animals in mountains. Animals in mountains have a thick fur to protect themselves from the cold. Example, yak. Some are sure-footed, so they can climb vertical rocks and sit on narrow ledges. Example, mountain goat. Desert animals. Desert animals have broad padded feet to walk comfortably on sand. They have long thick eyelashes to protect them from sandstorms. Example, camel. Animals in cold feel warm and get submerged in their surroundings. Example, polar bear. Arboreal animals. Animals which spend a lot of time on trees are called arboreal animals. They have strong limbs with sharp claws to climb trees. Monkey and chameleon have long tails to grip the branches. The tails also help them to balance their body. Example, panda, squirrel. Aerial animals. Animals which fly in air are aerial animals. Birds have wings to fly. They have hollow bones to fly. Example, kingfisher, eagle. Aquatic animals. Animals that live in water are called aquatic animals. Fish have fins to swim. Some animals which live inside water have gills to breathe. Some breathe through lungs, so they come out to breathe air. Water birds have webbed feet to paddle in water. Example, dolphin, turtle. Amphibians. Animals which live on both land and in water are called amphibians. Baby frogs are called tadpoles. They have gills for breathing. Frogs have lungs to breathe on land and when in water breathe through skin. They have webbed hind feet to swim. Example, salamander, green tree frog. Based on food, animals are classified into three groups. They are herbivore, carnivore, and parasite. Herbivore. Animals that eat plants are called herbivores. They have sharp teeth for biting and cutting. Example, rabbit, horse. Carnivores. Animals that eat the flesh of other animals are called carnivores. Most carnivores animals have very sharp teeth for tearing out the flesh of its prey. Example, lion, tiger, fox, and owl. Parasite. Some small animals get their food from other living organisms. They get their food by sucking the blood of their host. They may live on or inside the body of their host. Example, leech, fleas, and hookworm. Survival. Many animals have adapted themselves to the environment and to protect themselves from their enemies. Some animals have body color or shape that blends with their surroundings to hide from enemies. Hunting animals have stripes or spots to blend with the habitat. Some have quills and scales to protect themselves from enemies. Example, lion, grasshopper. Camouflage. Some animals can trick their enemies because their body color easily blends with their surroundings. This is known as camouflaging. Some can also change its body color according to the surroundings. Example, grasshopper, stick insect, and chameleon. Let's get back to our quiz pictures. In the first picture, most of you might have recognized the grey nightjar, but you might have surely missed the babies on the right side. The second picture was easy, and you might have recognized the owlet in the bark. The third one was not a grass twig, but the stick insect. All these are great examples of camouflage for survival. Attack and defense. Some have quills which are loose and stick to the skin if touched. They cause painful wounds and even infection. Some have backs covered with overlapping scales. They roll itself into a ball when it senses danger. Example, porcupine, pangolin. So, today we have learned about how animals adapt to different behavioral and physical changes based on their habitat, their food requirements, and for their survival. The next time you read about or see an animal in the wild, or when you see one on television, think about its adaptations. Thank you for watching. The next time I'll be back with another interesting topic. Till then, bye-bye.